Snow White is a 19th century German fairy tale that is today known widely across the Western world. The Brothers Grimm published it in 1812 in the first edition of their collection Grimm's Fairy Tales and numbered as Tale 53. The original German title was Schneewittchen, a Low German form, but the first version gave the High German translation Schneeweißchen, and the tale has become known in German by the mixed form Schneewittchen. The Grimms completed their final revision of the story in 1854. The fairy tale features such elements as the magic mirror, the poisoned apple, the glass coffin, and the characters of the Evil Queen and the Seven Dwarfs. The Seven Dwarfs were first given individual names in the 1912 Broadway play Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, and then given different names in Walt Disney's 1937 film Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. The Grimm story, which is commonly referred to as Snow White, should not be confused with the story of Snow White and Rose Red, in German Schneeweißchen und die Rosenrot, another fairy tale collected by the Brothers Grimm. In the Arne, Thompson folklore classification, tales of this kind are grouped together as type 709, Snow White. Others of this kind include Bella Venezia, Mersenne, Nuri Hadig, Gold Tree and Silver Tree, The Young Slave, and La Petite Taubelle. At the beginning of the story, a queen sits sewing at an open window during a winter snowfall when she pricks her finger with her needle, causing three drops of red blood to drip onto the freshly fallen white snow on the black windowsill. Then, she says to herself, "How I wish that I had a daughter that had skin as white as snow, lips as red as blood and hair as black as ebony." Sometime later, the queen gives birth to a baby daughter whom she names Snow White, but the queen dies in childbirth. A year later, Snow White's father, the king, marries again. His new wife is very beautiful, but she is a vain and wicked woman who practices witchcraft. The new queen possesses a magic mirror, which she asks every morning, "Magic mirror on the wall, who is the fairest one of all?" The mirror always tells the queen that she is the fairest. The queen is always pleased with that response because the magic mirror never lies. But when Snow White is 7 years old, her fairness surpasses that of her stepmother. When the queen asks her mirror, it tells her that Snow White is the fairest. This gives the queen a great shock. She becomes envious, and from that moment on, her heart turns against Snow White, whom the queen grows to hate increasingly with time. Eventually, the angry queen orders a huntsman to take Snow White into the forest to be killed. As proof that Snow White is dead, the queen demands that he returns with her heart, which she will consume in order to become immortal. The huntsman takes Snow White into the forest, but after raising his dagger, he finds himself unable to kill her when Snow White learns of her stepmother's evil plan and tearfully begs, "Spare me this mockery of justice, I will run away into the forest and never come home again." After seeing the tears in the princess's eyes, the huntsman reluctantly agrees to spare Snow White and brings the queen the heart of an animal instead. After wandering through the forest for hours, Snow White discovers a tiny cottage belonging to a group of seven dwarfs. Since no one is at home, she eats some of the tiny meals, drinks some of their wine, and then tests all the beds. Finally, the last bed is comfortable enough for her, and she falls asleep. When the dwarfs return home, they immediately become aware that there has been a burglar in their house, because everything in their home is in disorder. Prowling about frantically, they head upstairs and discover the sleeping Snow White. She wakes up and explains to them about her stepmother's attempt to kill her, and the dwarfs take pity on her and let her stay with them in exchange for a job as a housemaid. They warn her to be careful when alone at home and to let no one in while they are working in the mountains. 10 years later, Snow White grows into an absolutely lovely, fair, and beautiful young maiden. Meanwhile, the queen, who believes she had gotten rid of Snow White a decade earlier, asks her mirror once again, "Magic mirror on the wall, who now is the fairest one of all?" The mirror tells her that not only is Snow White still the fairest in the land, but she is also currently hiding with the dwarfs. The queen is furious when she learns that Snow White used her wits to fake her death by tricking the huntsman, and decides to kill the girl herself. First, she appears at the dwarf's cottage, disguised as an old peddler, and offers Snow White colorful, silky laced bodices as a present. The queen laces her up so tightly that Snow White faints or collapses. The dwarfs return just in time, and Snow White revives when the dwarfs loosen the laces. Next, the queen dresses up as a comb seller and convinces Snow White to take a beautiful comb as a present. She strokes Snow White's hair with the poisoned comb. The girl is overcome by the poison from the comb, but she is again revived by the dwarfs when they remove the comb from her hair. Finally, the queen disguises herself as a farmer's wife and offers Snow White a poisoned apple. Snow White is hesitant to accept it, so the queen cuts the apple in half, eating the white, harmless, half and giving the red poisoned half to Snow White. The girl eagerly takes a bite and then falls into a coma or appearing to be dead, causing the queen to think she has finally triumphed. This time, the dwarfs are unable to revive Snow White, and, assuming that the queen has finally killed her, they place her in a glass casket as a funeral for her. The next day, a prince stumbles upon a seemingly dead Snow White lying in her glass coffin during a hunting trip. After hearing her story from the seven dwarfs, the prince is allowed to take Snow White to her proper resting place back at her father's castle. All of a sudden, while Snow White is being transported, one of the prince's servants trips and loses his balance. This dislodges the piece of the poisoned apple from Snow White's throat, magically reviving her. The prince is overjoyed with this miracle, and he declares his love for the now alive and well Snow White, who, surprised to meet him face to face, humbly accepts his marriage proposal. The prince invites everyone in the land to their wedding, except for Snow White's stepmother. The queen, believing herself finally to be rid of Snow White after 10 years, again asks her magic mirror who is the fairest in the land. The mirror says that there is a bride of a prince, who is yet fairer than she. The queen decides to visit the wedding and investigate. Once she arrives, the queen becomes frozen with rage and fear when she finds out that the prince's bride is her stepdaughter, Snow White herself. The furious queen tries to sow chaos and attempts to kill her again, but the prince recognizes her as a threat to Snow White when he learns the truth from his bride. As a punishment for the attempted murder of Snow White, the prince orders the queen to wear a pair of red-hot iron slippers and to dance in them until she drops dead. With the evil queen finally defeated and dead, Snow White has taken her revenge, so her wedding to the prince peacefully continues. Many scholars have theorized about the possible origins of the tale. In 1994, a German historian named Eckhard Sander published Schneewittchen, Märchen oder Wahrheit? Snow White, Fairy Tale or Truth, claiming he had uncovered an account that may have inspired the story that first appeared in Grimm's Fairy Tales. According to Sander, the character of Snow White was based on the life of Margarethe von Waldeck, a German countess born to Philip IV in 1533. At the age of 16, Margarethe was forced by her stepmother, Katharina of Hatzfeld, to move away to Brussels. There, Margarethe fell in love with a prince who would later become Philip II of Spain. Her father and stepmother disapproved of the relationship, however, deeming it politically inconvenient. Margarethe mysteriously died at the age of 21, apparently having been poisoned. Historical accounts point to the King of Spain who, in opposing the romance, may have dispatched Spanish agents to murder her. Scholar Graham Anderson compares the story of Snow White to the Roman legend of Cain, recorded in Ovid's Metamorphoses. The name Cain means snow in Greek and, in the story, she is described as the most beautiful woman in the land, so beautiful that the gods Apollo and Hermes both fell in love with her. Hermes put her to sleep with the touch of his caduceus and raped her in her sleep. Then Apollo, disguised as an old crone, approached her and raped her again. These affections led Cain to openly boast that she was more beautiful than the goddess Diana herself, resulting in Diana shooting her through the tongue with an arrow. Karl-Heinz Bartels, a pharmacist and scholar from Lohr am Main, a town in northwestern Bavaria, found evidence that Snow White was Maria Sophia Margarethe Katharina, Baroness von Undizio Erthal, who was born in Lohr on June 25, 1725. Her father, Philip Christoph von Undizio Erthal, was the local representative of the Prince Elector of Mainz after the death of Maria Sophia's birth mother in 1738, her father remarried in 1743. The stepmother, Claudia Elizabeth von Reichenstein, was domineering and employed her new position to the advantage of her children from her first marriage. A magic mirror referred to as the talking mirror, known as always telling the truth, can still be viewed today in the Spessart Museum in the Lohr Castle, where Maria Sophia's stepmother lived. This mirror was presumably a present from Maria Sophia's father to his second wife. It was a product of the Lohr mirror manufacturer, Kermainzisk Spiegelmanufaktur. Her gravestone was found in 2019. Which Disney princess is your favorite and why? Let us know in the comments below the video, and tell us your favorite parts. Like, spam, and share the video.